Right then, the Legion servers are down, Warcraft, so I am going to be starting a new Navezgane game, because one day Alpha 15 is going to drop, there'll be no more Alpha 14. Standard options for me, shortish night time, zombies running, got backpack only on death, stuff like that. I haven't played much Navezgane on Alpha 14, I vaguely remember it from Alpha 12. The great snow biome, right. I remember the snows in the north, so I need to get some grass. Those things. Wood. As soon as you've got an axe, the best thing to do is go straight for a tree. Get plenty of wood a lot faster than going around punching things or chopping up little trees. For a start, let's get some stone and feathers. Number one thing to get hold of is a bow and arrow. Melee at this level is ridiculous hard. Some fibers so I can make a bedroll and some clothes. Now it's tempting to go around looting cars and stuff like that when you first start, but the thing is, I think it's more important to get the basics sorted. It finds the most safe for the night, especially when you've got runners like I've got. Another top tip when you're starting is follow the roads. Not the paths, or follow the paths till you get to a road, and then follow the roads. Roads usually lead to settlements, settlements where all the good loot is. Okay, I'm going to skirt this garage for now. I don't want to start a stupid fight with 9 arrows. Especially in the snow. But a garage is a good place to stop on your first night. Get up on the roof. Fair amount of decent loot in it. Good transitional base. Coal for torches, of course, that'll be useful later. Well, the road's bending south this way, so I'll stick to the road for now. Well, that might make a nice place to stop, but what I'm going to do is try and push on to more buildings. What I want is a load of houses to get the basics, like cooking pots and everything. Still got nearly all the day to do it, so... You might notice I don't use all my stamina up when I'm sprinting. It's because I like to keep a bit in the tank just in case something pops up at me. Is that Dyville? do these quests to get them out of the way. Right, running short on stone. Give me some more wood, and my axe is about to break. So let's hit the next boulder. No axe. Crouching is very useful when you're using a bow and arrow because you can use the eye dot in the centre of it. As a reticle, if you like, very accurate. New axe. Probably heading around there, west side. That's a very rough guess. It might be over here. Let's see. I think what I'll aim to do is build a base near the farm and near the tool shop. Good spot around there, near the river as well for the water. When you're looking for a base spot, you're looking for something, well, I'm looking for something that's not actually on a point of interest, a house or something. I wouldn't upgrade a house myself, I'd build my own base from scratch. But you want to be near lots of other things, so you should spend half your time running to get to the places you want to get to. Now what I should get is a bone shiv. Oh, where's the river? Next, lead to the bridge, which will lead to the tool shop. I should get a bone so I can start skinning, because my big priority is to get a forge going. These are essential, obviously. And so, need a lot of leather for them. Get that, I'm going to have to skin a lot of animals, and to do that I'm going to need a bone shiv. Can get bone shifts from zombies though, which is quite useful. Or bones. Okay, I could build on this side, but I don't think I like being that close to the town. Then again, yeah, this ain't bad. I'll have to knock these stones down eventually. Right, start a base then. Another big tip, cut all the grass down around your base as far as possible. When you're bored, you've got nothing to do, cut some grass, because the grass doesn't grow back and it lets you see dogs and crawlers and spiders a lot easier. Otherwise they tend to vanish in the grass. That's a temporary bedroll just in case I get killed. One of the key things about this game is time management, especially when you've got running zombies at night. So do as much as you can in the day, but also store up things to do at night. I mean, I like underground bases, so at night I'm generally digging underground or mining or making stuff up downstairs. And during the day, do as much as you can. Need a lot of wood. What I'm going to start with is a basic tower, which is high enough to be out of reach of the zombies. Inside there, I can start my first underground shaft. I'm basically going to build a complex underground with tunnels going out so I can pop up in various places, have a forge room far away from my base, you know, that sort of thing. Have a bigger one than usual, just for fun. Yet another tip, when you're putting campfires above ground, put them away from your base, just in case you start attracting screamers far away, but somewhere you can find them, like on a road. Not that it's a lot of use to me at the moment, because I haven't got a cooking pot, but I'll be alright for now. What I'm really concentrating on now is getting a tower up so I've got somewhere safe for the night. I'm going to neglect looting for food and stuff, and even hunting animals unless one wanders through, because I can probably survive until tomorrow. If I get the chance, I wouldn't mind a bit of food. At the start, you can never have too many frames. They're useful for lots of things. Need some ladders as well at some point. You might notice I ain't spending skill points yet. That's because I'm probably going to save them for mining. Yeah. On the other hand, if I found a shotgun or something, I might suddenly spend them on shotguns or whatever. And take it all the way down. Get the bones as well. And then I'm going to run away because I'm carrying meat, which is always a bad idea, of course. Never have too much wood in this game, even at the very later levels when you've got your own tree farms and everything. You would just use wood for everything, really. Cooking, building, tools, crafting. Always need the wood. Now I've got wood. Okay, no, they're not. Top tip, if you don't know it, don't put a ladder on the bottom one. Zombies can climb them. Always leave a gap. And then, whenever you want to climb a ladder, take a little jump at the bottom. Get on the ladder. Friend. There's a chicken over there, but I ain't going to go chasing him through the grass because they tend to vanish in grass. I'll wait till I've got a decent gun. Very good for feathers, though, chickens. Double tap. Rule one. I can't remember if that's rule one or rule two. Definitely an important one. Put this meat away before it attracts too much attention. I'm actually going to want my ladder going up there, because otherwise, when I run up this, there's a chance I'll run off the edge. That's no good. I couldn't see that ladder in the way. Mm. Okay, time's ticking on. Let's get the walls up a bit more. Hello, mate. Now, I'm going to have to stop in 10 minutes to sort the kids out. Oh, hello, mate. No, this is a PC version of 7 Days to Die, mate. Yeah, like I say, I'm going to have to stop in 10 minutes. I thought I'd just do a quick introductory video because the Warcraft servers are down. Generally not playing much 7 Days to Die at the moment because I'm waiting for Alpha 15. But I thought I'd do a quick one in case someone's new to the game, because I know a couple of people who've tried it and have found it really hard to get into. But the thing is, if you... Once you pick up the basics, it's such a brilliant game. It's a shame people miss out. But I might come back and do some more of this later. The servers aren't back up for Warcraft. New to the game. Have you got it? Definitely worth a pop if you can get it. Like I say though, it can be very confusing when you first play because there's so much to do. You just don't know the things you shouldn't do, like running into town or eating raw eggs, stuff like that. Now I'm playing on a level where the zombies run at night, which is default. And it's a good idea not to be outside at night, basically. I don't know. About 9 o'clock. Well, it's British summertime, 9 o'clock, so that's about half an hour or so. I mean, the main reason I'm on here is because I was watching some of the 7 Days to Die development teams, Madmole. He's doing a Let's Play of the latest version, which isn't released yet, Alpha 15. It just made me want to play, you know. Any excuse. But I thought I'd start a new game. Yeah, I'm English, mate. Just occurred to me that I might have time to run into town and grab a cooking pot if I get lucky. Make things interesting. It gets proper dark at 10 o'clock and I can see some houses over here. But if I get a cooking pot on my way, I can start making water. But I'll run into anything in here. nasty. Let's try down here. Can, but this town has got dogs in it. It means dogs spawn it, and dogs are one of the most dangerous things in this game. I prefer to have a base away from town, so I don't have to worry about them spawning around me. It's alright, if you're absolutely stuck when you're first playing, and it's like night time, I'd hide in a house or something. I prefer to have a base away from them. I'm going to have to smash my way in. I was looking for a window I could get through, but not looking likely. Oh, that's good. Unlocked. And that's all I want. I'm not going to hang about now. I'm going to run for it. Yeah, I've got pot, man. Right, well, I'm going to have to leave it about there. I'll just finish this dude off. I'll be back in a bit. Except I left all my arrows inside. Unlucky. Okay, got a cooking pot, means I can cook water to make it safe. That's pretty good for a first day, out of a base. I'll be back in half an hour, thank you for watching. No, this is a single player. I do often play multiplayer, but at the moment me and the other bloke who play a lot, generally not bothering, because we've played so much Alpha 14 there ain't much point. We're just waiting for the next one. Alright, see you in a bit.